This is FYI on Your TV, brought to you by Hometown News. I'm Kathy Botham. I have got Amanda Foster with me. You are the CEO and the Chief Librarian at our Smith Falls Public Library. Welcome back. It's been a little while.
Yeah, it's been probably close to a couple of years now.
Yeah, I think we had you on here to introduce you as the new CEO of our library too. So we've got through COVID, things are opening up. You've got lots of things going on at the public library too. So maybe the first thing we can talk about is the Board Game Cafe.
Yeah, so we've been having a lot of people that seem super interested. So we're hoping that will actually translate to people coming in, because interest on Facebook versus people actually coming in the door doesn't always translate, but we're really hoping it translates with this one. So yeah, we're going to be trying it for February and March. And if it's successful, I think it could go on further, but definitely February and March. It'll be every Wednesday from 5 to 6:45. There'll be free coffee courtesy of Mighty Valley, and they'll have a different roast provided every week. We have different games. They'll vary, but we've got games such as Pandemic, for example, murder mystery games, that kind of thing.
And is this an adult program?
Yes, it's for adults.
Okay. Now let's talk. I've got to mention too, one of your events, I was at the Pokemon Day. It was before Christmas, I believe.
It was a PD day.
Oh my goodness, what a successful event. So many children there, and it just was amazing. Yeah. And it was Deborah, your librarian upstairs, arranged all this, and it was just many children.
Yeah, she did a lot of it. And also Ashley, who does the teen adult programming, she did a lot with that too. So I don't want her to be forgotten.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. That was such a successful event. It was a fun day for the kids. So what else have we got going? March break is coming up, and you've got superheroes theme.
Yeah, we're going to have the whole week of superhero themed events. We haven't got the schedule out quite yet, but that's going to be the theme. And yeah, we're hoping it'll be popular like Pokemon was.
Oh, and you know what? I'm seeing families pulling out some Halloween costumes that they thought they'd never use again. They'll be able to get another wear out of it. So that you'll have a calendar of events going on for the week?
Yeah, we definitely will. It'll probably be into February, but we definitely will have that out.
Excellent. Now, can you talk about the escape room? You have an escape room. Whereabouts in the library is it?
So we're hoping it depends, but probably if things don't change, we've got kind of a back corner in the basement that we're hoping to repurpose, but it, isn't happening quickly. So that's where we've done our last couple escape rooms. But if, by some miracle, we end up moving forward on our plans for that room a little quicker, we'll have an alternate location for it.
Excellent. Those are so popular. People love escape rooms right now.
Yeah, we've definitely, all the other ones we've had have, sold out quite quickly. The Stranger Things one, we were only originally going to do it for two nights, and then we ended up having a third night of it. So the plan during March break is to have it a little more, it'll be all ages, but a little more family friendly.
Excellent. So lots to do during March break at our public library. So that's wonderful. I love the superheroes themes. We're going to get some Halloween costumes back out there. Now, you've got all sorts of things going on. I wrote down some things that are going on, but you've got a bigger list than I do. Thursdays, you have teen night there?
Yes. So we have teens. That's every Thursday. Basically, we advertise every week what it is. But, once a month, it tends to be a game. Sometimes it's a craft night. Just various things. Sometimes it's like food related. So, yeah, lots of fun things for teens. We ask that they register, but often there is, space for a couple more if they do just show up. So.
Excellent. Now, you've got
kind of a core group, but, definitely we could use a few more people.
This has been going on for a long time, this one
program. It has. Yeah. I think it's evolved a bit over the years. It used to be, it used to be very, very huge. Now it's more a little more like week by week, theme by theme. So it's a bit of a smaller group, but it's more of a planned program, I guess you'd say.
Okay. And you've got family literacy. What is that about?
So yeah, Family Literacy Day is technically Friday the 27th, but we're going to have our event on the 28th, the Saturday, just because we figured we'd get more people in the door. So it's an annual event, and it's just kind of to, promote, literacy for the whole family. So it's just kind of like a fun day of activities for families.
Excellent. Now, this is very interesting too, and I think this is a great program. Your French story time is for children.
So yeah, it's like a preschool story time, but it's in French, and we've been having it for a while, but we've had, you know, very low attendance. So we're moving it to see if, you know, different day and time might make it, you know, more popular. So we're going to be having it on the new date. It's going to be Monday, January 30th at 10 a.m. So, I mean, it's just, yeah, you drop in, it's, you know, a story time, but it's in French. And it, you know, it's, we have an outside person who comes in who's, you know, fluent in French. So it's a great way to expose kids to French before they go to school.
And I was going to make that point too. It's a great way to expose them to French. When you know your children are going to go into French immersion, you can start them when they're young. They learn so much when they're young.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Like there's so many studies on it. Yes. You know, kids when they're, you know, I can't remember the exact age, but before about 6 or 7, just, yeah, they learn languages so much easier than you're ever going to learn them when you're older.
Absolutely.
So it's a great time.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, is there anything else going on? I know you've got so many programs going on there too, but your story time?
Yeah, just sort of our always program. So we're continuing. We still have 2 book clubs going. They're both the first week of the month. Tuesday mornings, we have one that meets in the library. And then Wednesday evenings, we have one that meets at Boston Pizza. You know, it's, you know, a bit more informal. That one definitely could use more members. So, yeah, we have on our website, we've got the books listed. So, you know, it's great to join and come every month. But if you want to just come when you actually want to read the book, that's fine, too. We're very open that way. And then our regular English language story times, we've got for 1 to 5 year olds, Tuesday and Friday mornings at 10:30. And then we've got our baby time, for kids under a year at 11:15 on Friday. So those are all just drop in the story times.
And you know, those are great programs for the children, but it's a wonderful way for parents and caregivers to get together too.
Yeah, we've definitely found that we've been getting a lot of families that are new to town. So, but you know, again, if you've been here forever, that's fine too. But yeah, I think the parents sometimes get as much out of it as the kids.
Oh, okay. Now, I noticed on your Facebook page, you had some books, top circulating books, I believe, from the library. And last year, one of our top circulating nonfiction books for 2022 was our Smith Falls book.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it's an older book, but I mean, people are definitely still interested in local history. And, you know, we definitely have a bunch of local history books, but that one in particular has remained popular.
Excellent. And you know, I do, people randomly ask, you know, where could I get a copy of it? And I always point them in the direction of the library. I don't know where we can buy them anymore, but I always say there's I know you have at least one at the library, but you probably
have
a couple.
Yeah, I'd have to look it up, but I believe we have several. I think there's at least one that's non-circulating, and then we've, you know, got at least a copy that's circulating. So it's available.
Excellent. Now, you've got a great Facebook page, and you can take a look at that. So much stuff that's going on at our library right now, too. How else do people get a hold of you?
And you can be, you know, old-fashioned and just phone us. Our number is 613-283-2911. Or, you know, just drop in and talk to us. Like, you know, anytime we're open, you know, just come on in. You know, it's open to anyone anytime we're open. So
can you tell the hours? Because I think your hours are wonderful. You're so accessible.
Yeah,
we did
actually change them last July. And we've been, you know, just because before we were very evening focused and we found that wasn't when people are coming in. So Mondays and Tuesdays, 10 to 5. Wednesdays and Thursdays, 12 to 7, and then Friday and Saturday, 10 to 5 again.
Excellent, excellent. Now, I don't go during the day very often, but when I do, I notice there's people that go in there and they're just using computers, they're just coming in to read the newspaper, that sort of thing. Those sort of things are accessible to them too.
Oh yeah, we have free Wi-Fi. Our Wi-Fi, it didn't used to be, but now it's pretty fast, so that's good. And yeah, you can come use a computer, you can print things off, you can study. Really, as long as you don't run through here screaming, you can pretty much do what you want, right? It's, you know, we'd like to be welcoming. It's okay. If you want to sit here from 10 to 5 all day, again, as long as you're not doing something really disruptive, we don't care. Like, you know, we're free, we're open, you can loiter all day.
Well, and you know, I'm sure people go to the library to get away from screaming and running around at their own home, so maybe some quiet time at the library. For sure, for sure. Well, thank you very much for joining us. I've got Amanda Foster, 2 years as our CEO at our Smith Falls Public Library, the chief librarian as well too. Can people still get books? I know you were doing them during COVID, they could pick them up in the back. Are you still doing
that? Yeah, we still do that. I mean, I will say it isn't really that popular. I think we're doing it maybe 5 times a month. But yeah, if that works better for you, let us know when it is possible.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Well, thank you very much for joining us and telling us what's going on at our Smith Falls Public Library. Thanks, Amanda.